Hi, my name is Nadia Jabour. I'm the owner of Designs by Nadia. I made jewelry, I supplied hotels, we did road shows, I did all the shows on the streets, we had flea markets, we had home shows. So I've done the entire gamut of sales to where we are today. So the grant that I got, I used it on marketing and branding and going to trade shows within the Caribbean and one in Canada. So I opened up Trinidad, Barbados, Grenada, and some of the Grenadine Islands. And then later on I got Jamaica, Barbados, Guyana, right? I opened up those markets and I started to sell within little boutiques in the Caribbean. I realized that we needed to have a place where we could call home, all the artisans can call home, and it has brought me to this today. I have two assistants, two full-time staff that help me with making jewelry. So it's a lot of wire wrapping, dyeing. I use a lot of fabric dyes to dye fish scales into different colors. I use leather dyes on my, of course, leather pieces, and leather dye is also used on my coconut pieces, so that's how you get the vibrance in them. Working within the islands and trying to get pieces out to the islands, it was difficult in terms of getting, first of all, getting to know where I can export, or who is it that needs my pieces. But getting the pieces there is costly for us. And I think this is a challenge that all artisans have. But my goal is to put my jewelry in most of the islands so that I can be an example to other artisans that it can work. What I have gotten from Caribbean Export is the exposure, the knowledge, the understanding of all the different markets that you have to deal with. Each of my lines are tweaked now to where I am going. I make it a study of understanding the markets I'm going to. You have to, first of all, believe in yourself, believe in your product, and then others will believe in you.